I am so excited for that game, though.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mario Strikers.
Yeah, this will be fun.
Like, I think I could play that online. I just can't do Pokemon Unite. I just can't do it.
Yeah, that's fair. This would be more fun.
It makes me so mad. Because I get fucking ganged up on, and it's like, why? Why?
And it being kind of pay to win doesn't help.
Yeah, that really doesn't. Because it's like, I'm not going to pay to win.
Yeah, exactly.
Did you get to see the... Did I show you that?
I think I watched it.
Oh, okay. What else is there? Well, you already know about that, so... Let's see. Oh, I gotta show you this really cool game that I played the demo for. It's called Triangle Strategy. It's so... Oh, it's so good. I cannot wait for it to come out. Like, Square Enix went back to, like, their old school Final Fantasy days for this game.
Oh, no.
Moon Pie?
Nah.
Okay. I thought it was mostly Pop Tarts. Like, the gimmick in this game is there's three factions, and your actions, like, you'll have positive and negative effects for both factions when you make choices.
That's cool.
So, like, the outcome of the game is always different. And it's got, like, 2.5D, like, battles and shit. Right. So, like, there's different levels of the world that you can be on. If that makes sense. Yeah. Like, you can be on a platform over here, and there could be a soldier above you, like, five platforms.
Oh, okay, I see.
A new future is before us. A bright future. Today, we fight not for glory or pride, but for survival. For the future. The future of Glenbrook lies in
Mars. Like, it looks good. And it makes me, like, nostalgic. Because, like, when I started playing games, I was playing on a Game Boy Color. And an NES, you know?
Yeah. Fuck it, I'll try that moon pie.
Already knew it.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Marshmallow. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Like, if I remember correctly, I think, like, winter's coming for the land that you're in, and you've got to, like, try to unite the three factions or something. But if you, like, make a choice that one faction likes, the other one might not like it. So that makes it harder for you to try to convince them to...
Yeah, I like that. That's cool.
Like, it's got a real moral system. And so you have to think about everything you do. Like, you can walk up to a guy and be like, I like pancakes. And he can be like, but I like waffles. You're gonna die.
I promise to do all in my power to see
Damn, that's pretty damn good.
I've been seeing people buy them. I'm like, oh man. Oh yeah, you can get the demo for it on your Switch. Around and around and around we go. Where we stop, nobody knows.
Yes.
You're gonna like this episode.
Yeah. You don't really need to get glasses, man. You just say worms.
No, I will. I will get them eventually. I'm just way too busy to go to the optometrist.
You've been saying that for like 7 months, man.
Hello? Uh-huh. Yep. Okay. Okay, sure. Boys, I just got a call from a young man who sounded absolutely distressed. Can you head over and help him before he goes, coo-coo, coo-coo, coo-coo?
Sure, yeah, we'll gladly help. You're energetic today, Mr. Boss.
Probably because I ate up some of them worms earlier.
They put worms in because Zach liked to play worms on Oni Plays. And he said he was going to put a worm in an episode.
Oh.
Smiley Friends, are you
the
guy that called?
Yes, I called. It is I, Shrimp. That is my name.
Okay, Shrimp, what's going on, man?
Sorry, my girlfriend just broke up with me. I am heartbroken.
No.
That's David Firth. That's Sally Fingers.
Oh, okay.
You can hear it now that I put it out, can't you?
Yeah, it's been a long time, but.
But I do not want a new girl. I just want Trimpina back.
Yeah, Charlie, he can win her back. I just think he needs to tell her how he feels.
Mouse Quest.
That's a real game they play on Roadie Plays.
It's real.
It's real.
What? And now,
if you think that's gonna work, go for it. All right, I'm gonna stay back here and help Shrimp Slide get back on track.
I'm sure it's gonna work. Shrimp, where can I find Shrimpina?
She works at 153 Meat Boulevard.
Are you really gonna do this?
That's the difference between you and me, Charlie.
Dude, he's slamming hard for just walking straight.
Yeah.
Shrimp, you don't need to get back with your ex. All right, you need to get your life in order. Only then. Excuse me, heavens. Well, we'll be
in chat. Excuse fuck? Me, heavens.
Sunlight here.
No.
Sorry. Okay, we'll
search. Holy fuck.
153 Meat Boulevard. This is the place.
Number 15.
There's chills.
I get the number 15.
Sure thing, hon.
Oh my god. That's Shrimpina? Hi there. How's it going?
What can I get for you?
Actually, I just wanted to give you these. They're not from me. They're from your secret admirer.
Secret admirer? Oh, my. This is all so sudden. I was just in the process of moving on.
This particular person just wanted you to know that he really cares about you.
I like your hair.
Oh, this old thing? Yeah, it's actually just an exposed nerve ending. But thanks. Anyway.
Reminds me of a little piece of spaghetti or something.
Oh, you like spaghetti?
I love spaghetti. Especially the spaghetti they make at Spaghetti Disco. It's ever so delectable.
Oh, well, funny you say. Your secret admirer wants to take you to dinner there tonight.
Really? Gosh, that all sounds so romantic.
Oh, great. So you'll be there at Spaghetti Disco at 7?
Sure, I'll go. After all, I do believe in destiny. Oh my gosh!
What the fuck?
I just had a bad batch of worms earlier. Well, alright, goodbye! Alright, now that we've got you out of the house, the next thing is dressing like an actual adult. Alright, first off...
Should the guy run out of the coat?
Oh, I saw him run off, but...
He came out of the coat, real! This is what I showed you when we went to the cow patty.
Oh.
You look like you're about to tell your friend not to come to school tomorrow, man. But that's nothing a tan can't fix. Wow, look at that. You've got that iconic shrimp glow that everyone's talking about.
Oh my god.
Look, shrimp. Dude, you just let that guy take a bite out of you. Why did you fight back?
I am too scared of confrontation. Ah.
You know what? I think I finally know what your main problem is. The single best thing you could do to get your life in order and be attracted to chicks is to get in shape and become an alpha male like me. Okay, Shrimp, the easiest thing to start with is probably this 100-pound squat.
Yeah, no, what you need to do is get your posture right. You need to straighten your back and be aware
of... Yeah, this dude knows.
Your feet are all
right. Thanks, man. Yeah, for sure.
I mean, because what you're doing, the way you're doing that, you're going to pull something if you keep doing it.
Hey, thank you. We got it. We got it, man. Don't listen to him. He's just showing off. All right, now do it the way I told you to do it.
Okay.
What the fuck? It was so big. Jesus.
Little fucking Charlie in the back.
This is disturbing. Was that a happy dream?
Yeah.
She wasn't interested. There's not gonna be a day.
Oh, well, at least you tried. Hey, anyways, you wanna come help me with shrimp?
Nah, it's alright. You can finish the job without me.
What did the pink man say? When do I get to see my shrimpina again?
Look, I hate to be the one that brings this to you, shrimp, but, I don't think she wants to see you again, man.
Oh, I am going to be alone forever.
Why don't we go for a drink, man? It's on me.
Oh my god, he's so fragile.
I don't know if this is right. I've got to get out of here.
Oh, it's you. Is my secret admirer here yet?
Yeah. Look, before I get into any of that, I just wanted to tell you, when I first came to your work, it was for a different reason. But when I saw you, I felt something I've never experienced before. And I know this sounds crazy, but... Oh my god, Charlie and Shrimp are here?
God damn, Shrimp, you're just like,
fuck.
Man. And I ain't even trying to be offensive or nothing like that, but I don't know how you had a girlfriend in the first place.
That is why I do not even bother.
Oh yeah, I know. But I'm just saying, you're just like really, really fucked. I genuinely feel bad. It's not even your fault, man. You're just a shrimp. You was born like that. You was born like that. You was born a shrimp. You can't even, it's your nature.
So? What did you want to tell me?
Never mind. Come with me. Your secret admirer is actually over here.
Phil, what are you doing here?
Here he is. Shrimp was your secret admirer the whole time. This date was actually his idea. He really cares about you, and he'd love to give the relationship another chance.
What?
Shrimp.
Who is that?
Your ex-boyfriend, Shrimp. But you're Shrimpina, right?
My name is Jennifer.
I have never met this woman in my entire life.
Pim, who is this? Where did you meet this woman?
I went where Shrimp told me to go. The cafe on 153 Meat Boulevard.
Pim, there's no cafe at 153, there's a cafe at 158. You went to the wrong place.
Well, wait a second. What about that thing you said at the cafe? About, like, moving on or something?
Yeah, my boyfriend Jason died in a motorcycle accident a few months ago.
Jesus Christ, man, Pim. Pim.
Where is Shrimpina?
I have no idea. Probably at home. I don't know. Pim, did you even see Shrimpina one time, once?
Charlie, I don't know. I guess not.
So, do you like Mouse Quest?
Wait, are you serious? You're telling me you're a 4'6" shrimp with a receding hairline who loves Mouse Quest? You're literally everything I've ever dreamed about.
Oh my god.
Pim, her name was Shrimpina. She'd be a shrimp.
I did think that for a moment. I just thought it was like a quirky, like you didn't expect she was going to be a human thing.
Pim, this is so much worse than the worm stuff earlier. You really need to get your eyes checked.
No, I know. I'm going to do it first thing tomorrow. No, that was bad. I'm just as shocked as you are, Charlie.
Don't worry, Pim. I can cheer you up.
It's Mormo! You voted and we listened! This cannot be undone! Mormo is here to stay!
Fucking Smormu. Which episode is this? Is this the Halloween episode? I hope it is. Yes, it is. This is the best episode.
But today's people put down their newfangled gizmos and gadgets. For a brief moment, they'd probably start rambling on about nonsense like wars, plagues, and terrorist attacks. But they would neglect to mention for the actual horrors of reality, like witches, ghouls, and alien saucers. However, after tonight, you can add something else to that list. Be primal and disturbing horror of the unknown.
Charlie, what are you supposed to be?
He doesn't want to dress up as anything.
Listen, I've seen way too many people get their careers ruined over old Halloween costumes. I'm not doing it.
Why don't you just put on some face paint and be a zombie or something?
Dude, face paint gives people in way more trouble than anything else. I mean, I have no idea what's going to be offensive in 10 years.
Oh, come on, Charlie. Where's the Halloween spirit? When you put on a costume, you can be anything.
Pim, that's insane.
Could regular Pim be the sharpest gunslinger in the West?
You're not gonna hit
you
that.
You need to pick those up when you're done. Don't leave them all over the floor.
I'm 100% positive you're not gonna hit that. Okay, you actually hit it.
Oh my god, Alan!
I thought they could save Alan. I really didn't know we could do that.
It's fine. Just no more guns inside, okay? We're done with the gun stuff.
Everyone, I have some bad news. Halloween is canceled.
Aww.
Yeah. We're all out of firewood, and it's just not the same without a big Halloween fire pit. If only someone could wrangle up some firewood. Oh, well.
Oh, I could wrangle up some firewood.
Oh, damn, that's wonderful. Follow me, I'll show you where the good stuff is.
I love Mr. Boss.
See the woods over there?
Yeah.
So, I usually just go in there and pick some crap off the floor. And
oh, okay.
What?
Oh, I was just saying okay.
Oh, yeah, it's all good. But anyway, yeah, it's usually a little bit sparse this time of year. But if you look hard enough, you should be able to find something.
Yeah, that sounds pretty easy. I should be able to do that.
Great.
Oh my god.
You do? Don't go beyond the rickety bridge. Because
you get lost.
Tweets, I like picking up tweets.
please, and I want some more. Oh, thank you, Mr. Bird. These twigs are nice and all. I wish I had something with a bit more girth. Oh, that's more like it. What did the boss say about that rickety bridge again?
Don't go beyond the bridge. You'll get lost.
The boss did say not to go beyond the rickety bridge, but all the good firewood is there. This truly is a cowboy's dilemma. If I just mark the trees, like a true pioneer, I'll be able to find my way back no problem. Oh, whoops.
Now how could that go wrong?
Yeah. You'll get lost.
You're getting lost. Wait!
That was so fucked up.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck, bud.
I just broke the fucking clip off my pen.
Oh, bud.
Fuck, bud. This was a great idea. Like, I was like, oh, this is gonna be stupid at first, but this is great.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. You get lost.
Oh, come on, Pim, say fuck.
Oh. Oh, shit. Gotta do some Bear Grylls shit to get out of this.
How's that moon pie?
That's good as fuck, dude. I'm not gonna lie.
You want another one?
Yeah.
If you want some, I got a pack of brown sugar cinnamon Pop-Tarts.
Man, Pop-Tarts aren't the same.
Well, they're not, like, Pop-Tarts. They're, like, best choice, so they're better.
Yeah.
Like, best choice can't get a lot of things right, but
they're
Pop-Tarts.
In a good way.
Yeah, their Pop-Tarts are, like, good as fuck.
I like these motherfuckers.
Those are Little Debbie.
Mm.
I mean, Little Diabetes.
Beautiful.
That's the wrong end of the pen. Daddy Pim. Hello, Diddy 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 Pim. You need a pick for picking?
The
pick
who to what picking? What? A pick for picking?
Yeah. I mean, it'd be good to clean stuff. It's a soft metal, so it's not like it's...
Yeah, I'm right.
Say what you will, Pim's pretty good at making a lasso.
Yeah. That's true.
Ha 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 ha!
Their claymation is really good.
Oh my god. That's claymation?
Yeah.
That's creepy as fuck.
But it's like really good though.
Whoa. Yeah.
Is that fucking blackface, dude?
No. This isn't blackface. I'm an actual demon.
Bro, please tell me that's not blackface.
Old man.
No. You don't understand. I'm literally a forest demon from across the bridge. This isn't a costume.
Get the fuck out, man.
Oh my god. What? They just start eating him?
That's exactly why I don't dress up for Halloween. Right there. That's the reason.
Holy fuck. What?
Shit stain on his underwear.
What the fuck? Jesus.
It's really funny. This all came out after Christmas. And there's a Halloween episode. Like, they put all the episodes on one night. On Adult Swim.
Oh, okay.
Carrot concept.
Yeah, really? Okay. Well, to be completely fair, I did really enjoy the scene when Bibbler went rogue and beat that woman in the head with the hammer. I thought it was artistically, like, tastefully done. I thought it was a well-done sequence.
It's fine. That was the part I really didn't like. It's too violent.
I think it's just because he was a leech. And by the way, can you get some food?
Yeah, I could eat.
Where's that crack lighter?
Oh, I don't know. I didn't have a crack lighter.
Where's that motherfucker?
Oh, there.
So is a homunculus.
Charlie, this place doesn't seem very clean. There's grease all over the floor.
It's just part of the charm, man.
Welcome to Salty. I'm Simon the Salty, and I built this very restaurant with my own two hands. And together with my funny mascot friends, we work hard to give you the most quality, the supreme, to give you that quality Salty's experience. Unfortunately, the United States FDA,
FDA
is the my food of a hazard. In the past 4 months alone, although I'm rolling out some new and improved menu items. Come on, Italian. You could try my new cucumber deluxe, the super green bowl, and my personal favorite, Salty Salty Red Rust. Come to Salty's and get your new and
improved. I hate when fast food restaurants do this healthy food shit. First, they took out the century egg, and now this. Awesome.
What's a century egg?
Oh, it's like a Chinese egg that you bury in the dirt, and you dig it up and you eat it after like 100 days. I actually thought it was pretty good. I liked it.
I looked at how to make those, and it's only like 3 weeks it's got to be in the dirt with a bunch of shit. You don't even keep it in the dirt. You keep it in like the fridge or something. Wrapped in a bunch of shit. Oh, they look so awful.
It sounds awful.
What can I get you? Yeah, I'll just get 2 Salty Delight burgers, thanks.
Sorry, unfortunately, as of today, we don't sell the Salty Delight anymore. I can get you a salty sourdough bread bus, though.
What? Come on, you can't get rid of the Salty Delight. Let me talk to Salty.
Oh, Salty is actually taking his iconic 7 p.m. nap.
No, I think I'm gonna speak to him.
Iconic.
Oh, shit! Salty's being murdered!
Lieutenant Salty has been murdered.
Yeah, after some recent budget cuts, we're no longer in charge of murder mysteries. Another team handles that now.
They'll be on their way shortly.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Hello?
Hey, Charlie, the owner of the famous Salty's restaurant was just brutally murdered. I need you to pin to figure out who did it. Thank you, bye.
It looks like we're technically in charge of solving this.
I guess that means we're detectives now, Charlie.
Did you really bring that with you into the movie theater?
First things first, how many exits does this place have, Ketchup?
Just the front entrance!
Then that means the killer is still here in the restaurant.
Ketchup, who else was in the restaurant when we came in?
Just me, you guys, and all the other mascots.
What are the mascots?
Alright, so we have Mustard, Salt, Pepper, Crazy Cup, the Fun Twins, and me, Ketchup. I think that's everyone.
And don't forget about me, Grace. I could have done it.
Grace.
I mean, no, but I totally could have.
Cool. Anyways, as much as I love all you epic mascots, somebody here definitely murdered Simon S. Salty.
We should go around and get everyone's side of the story, then just see what sticks out.
Just wait. Just watch the episode.
You didn't need to raise your voice, man.
Alright, Ketchup. What was your relationship like with Salty?
Well, lately we have been having arguments about the new healthy menu. I just knew it was going to cause problems for the restaurant.
Sounds like you were quite angry at Salty then.
Yes, but I would never stab my friend in the back. Ooh, he was my dad.
He cries Ketchup.
To my children. Ooh.
Well, don't cry, Mr. Ketchup. We'll solve this mystery soon.
Thank you, Ben. All right, I'm not screwing around here. You two kill Salty or what?
Oh, no, never. We were spending all day draining the rotten soda from the machine with our soda draining device and refilling it with fresh Salty soda.
Yes, it's true. Oh, yes, yes, yes.
You guys spent all day doing that?
Well, not all day. We did have a little break to have a little kiss in the closet.
All right, noted. That's just straight up paper, by the way.
Look, I couldn't have killed Salty. I spent all day cleaning the stain off my costume.
A stain of what?
My own doo-doo feces, okay? I have a serious drug problem, which causes me to squirt out my ass into my costume. And the worst part of all is this thing takes 20 minutes to take off.
Oh, fair enough. I'm genuinely sorry, that sounds terrible.
Yeah, no dip.
Oh, I wish I could help, but I was in here all day just doing my routine stock check.
Okay, yeah, that actually checks out.
Oh, all right, fine. You pushed me hard enough, and now I'm forced to admit it. Yes, Salty and I were having a steamy affair. What of it? The last time I saw him, I was breaking up with him in his office. He was laying down to take his iconic 7 p.m. nap. I just couldn't keep it going on any longer. He was smothering me too much.
That's a bombshell. Could you expand on that a little bit more?
I'd never do anything to hurt him, if that's what you're getting at. Oh, murder is a terrible thing. Just the thought of it makes me ever so lightheaded. Oh! Can't a poor mustard like me ever have a little fun?
Yeah, everyone likes fun.
You like to have fun, too?
I mean, you know, you're asking about me. I mean, I like fun, yeah. You know.
Oh, yeah.
I already said yes.
All right, Charlie, you all done here? I think we just have one last interview left.
Yeah. Yeah, we're all done here.
We can have fun on the jungle gym after you tell me what you two were doing at the time of the murder.
That place is so fucked up.
Well, that's a nice story and all, but...
Yeah,
answer my question.
Tim, how did you understand any of that?
What?
This is tough. I really feel like any of these rotten mascots could have done it. What do you think, Tim?
I don't know, sorry, I can't even think properly right now. My arm is stinging so bad from whatever those fun twins spat on me.
Oh, it's just a little bit of playful spit, Pim. We're just having fun.
Salty must have some kind of cream or ointment around here.
It did seem odd that Mustard was having an affair with Salty. But also, that cup thing has got a bad energy about it, man. Just a bad vibe.
Wait a second. What room is this?
Secret room!
Uh-oh.
Oh, greetings.
Well, you're the century egg. They took you off the menu, right?
Yes, I was delicious. But the public wasn't ready for it, so I soaked terribly. And Salty took me off his damn menu and locked me away down here. And now you know my cool fucking backstory.
That is pretty cool.
Thank you.
Well, look, Salty was murdered, and we're trying to figure out who did it.
I knew this day would come.
you have any information that might help us out, Mr. Egg?
Yes, well, funny you say. I do happen to film everything that happens in Salty's office on my secret security camera. And you would be interested in anything like that.
No,
serious?
We definitely are.
I can feel the cold hands of death taking me away. You may have my tape. On the condition you bury me in the beautiful Chinese Shanghai Pine Forest, my hometown.
Oh yeah, we will definitely go to China and bury you, man.
Very well. It's over there in that drawer.
Thank you, Egg.
Listen up, everyone. We have it all right here on tape. Now we can see for ourselves what actually happened.
All right, rewind it. I knew it. It was ketchup.
I knew it was ketchup.
Charlie, you like our menu, right? Aren't you sick of seeing all your favorite fast food restaurants becoming healthy and cleaning up their image? Fast food should be greasy and make your heart palpitate.
Yeah, but I'd never break the sixth commandment, dude.
Wait a second. I think there's more.
What? So salt and pepper did it?
Fine.
Damn.
We drank all his blood because he didn't approve of us kissing on the job.
All right,
so they drained his blood.
They're still going.
All right, you got me.
They're all involved.
Yeah. How many fucking people did we just need to say you killed him first.
It seemed easier to kill him than to break his heart.
All right, I don't think we're going to get any more surprises, so I guess you really did do it.
Wait a second, there's a bit more footage left.
Wait, play from there.
My final murder. After today, I'm going to start eating coffee. My heart.
So I guess that means they're all innocent. Salty technically died from a heart attack.
I mean, all of these characters are definitely psychopaths, but I guess none of them killed him.
That means we legally can all go free. Yay!
I think there's laws about messing with corpses.
Alright, next time I'm picking the food.
What the fuck?
They're psychopaths!
Yeah, they are.
You're gonna like. Did you ever see the animated Hobbit movies?
No.
Like the really old. Oh.
what happened.
Got disconnected. Mm.
Sci-fi slash fantasy. Man, I am teased for carrying all this shit around all day.
As is meant, we shall set up camp and regain our strength for tomorrow.
But the castle is right there, Charlie.
How are you not tired of questing all day?
No, you've been questing all day.
Just have a little bit of fun, man. Relax.
Oh, Vic just hates nasty arguments.
Look what you did there. You scared off Vip.
Sorry about all the silly business back there, Vip.
Vip hopes he didn't cause that.
No, you're awesome, man. You couldn't have gotten as far without you.
Charlie, I think I found a hero ready to deliver my gift.
Who?
It's you, Charlie.
Vip, I'd be honored.
No, I'm the one who's honored to be in the presence of such a hero.
Well, maybe it was your song that helped you become a hero.
Well, maybe I like that.
Oh, God.
Vip is getting pretty sleepy. Maybe we should get some rest.
Yeah. Good idea. Good idea. What's going on here? Charlie knows how much I love the enchanted forest. Is he doing this on purpose? It's like I don't even exist. Ever since Mip came along. Mip. Pim, what are you doing?
Charlie, you don't even like the enchanted forest.
That's not yours, dear.
I deserve something. You could have all the fun. Now I'm gonna go in this package and do the final quest.
You're being weird, man. Let it go.
Please be very careful with this creation.
I earned it.
Really animated that fucking scene. Like, look at the detail on that spear.
Oh my.
Sorry about getting all rubbed up back there, Charlie. I also got carried away with that quest crap. I got stuck in a vicious dopamine cycle. You want to finish this last one together? Yeah.
For her map.
Oh, hello there. How can I help?
Hi. We're the Smiling Friends. We were sent here to help you smile for your portrait.
Oh, great. Yes, I've been unable to smile for a while now.
Well, before we help with that, we have something for you.
Oh, wow. Thanks. This is from you?
No, actually, it's from a good man. A forest folk named Mip, who sadly passed away on his journey here.
Did you just say Mip?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Did you know him?
He was the entire reason I haven't been able to smile for my portrait. He's my stalker.
What? Buddy?
No, seriously, I've blocked him on everything, and I've had to meet twice because of it. So, what's in the package then?
This is a really fucked up episode.
Yeah, he's dead. He's dead.
Oh, thank God.
good. So I guess we did it, right? We technically made you smile.
Yeah, I guess you did.
Cool.
Cool.
You
take an inventory of the fridge.
What the fuck? I'm just telling you what I'm reading here, man. That's all I know. You know as much as I know. I'm just reading off this thing. It says the Renaissance men are coming to town really soon.
Okay.
Like ASAP.
I just don't know what that means.
I don't know what that is.
What's that noise? I think it's that.
Grim and Graham.
Oh, not this guy again. He's gonna murder them. Straight up.
Oh my god, did I think he was gonna do that? That scared me. That actually scared me a little bit. Anyways, we'll see you later, man.
Yeah, dude. They're dead.
Come on, Charlie. Now that we've got competition, we can't afford to sit around in the break room all day. We've gotta get out there and get our hands dirty.
I'm not gonna hit him, man. I'm not gonna hit him. I'll run around and do whatever it is. Something
about this guy.
My shitty stuff, man. It makes me angry, man.
I don't mind it. You just need to keep working hard, man. You'll definitely find an audience. Practice makes perfect.
Hey, I just remember, you two little critters told me that, it would be easier if I just quit making music and, give the frig up and stuff, man.
No, we've never spoken to you, sir.
Yeah, no, I met you two, man. I freaking met you two. You're grim and you're gnarly and stuff, man.
Look, I see what's going on. Now, look. Those are just two guys who look like us.
Yeah, they just look like us.
Man, shut up, man! You're trying to trick me, man! Put smoke into my freaking head and shit, man!
Not at all, man.
Man, I don't know what to think no more, man!
Okay, alright.
Get out of the head! Get out of the head! Get out of the head, man! Nobody's watching me!
Hello, Mr. Man. We were just wondering if you needed cheering up today.
Well, the shape of my head causes me constant mental anguish. Does it sound like I need cheering up?
Yeah, a little bit.
In fact, didn't you two just come by and tell me I should feel bad about my disgusting head shape and shouldn't do anything to address it?
God damn it, man, they've got everyone.
No, sir, that wasn't us. Your head is stunning, by the way.
No, I've definitely seen you two before. You're trying to mess with me. Get out of my head! Get out of my head!
What the?
Look, Pim, I get what's going on here. They're the bizarro versions of us. That's fine. But what's their endgame? What's the point of this? It's just pissing me off now.
Let's try one more, Charlie. What about that guy?
Boo-hoo! Boo-hoo-hoo!
Hey there, little guy. What's got you upset?
Oh, boo-hoo! It's just that the world is so damn rotten. There's so much hate and evil. 3D Squelton just doesn't see a point in living anymore. What's the point? Oh, boo-hoo-hoo! 3D Squelton likes balloons.
Well, there you go. Balloon maker right there. Why don't you just get your license?
I'm sure a balloon profession will put a big old smile on your face.
Yeah, it kind of does.
About how much time and energy it would take to become a balloon salesman. And it doesn't matter because you will die one day.
Oh, no, but think about how good it'd feel once you finally did get the license.
But did you know that all of Earth's helium is running out and will be completely depleted within 15 to 20 years?
That's true, by the way.
Is that actually true?
What's going to be depleted?
The Earth's natural helium.
When it hurts. Anytime you feel like
it's like 20 to 25 years, but yeah, that's really going to fucking happen.
So what does that mean?
Like, the natural helium that the Earth has in its atmosphere is going to be gone.
Charlie, I don't think these guys want friendly competition with us at all.
Dude, I just looked at the helium thing he was talking about. That's true. That's like 100%. Everything he said was true. It's all going to be gone.
All right, guys. Things are looking pretty bleak. I'm down $2.5 million since this new company moved in across the street. Any ideas?
Don't worry, Mr. Rim. I had a similar problem when I acquired Wrigley's gum. You should just buy more stocks.
Well, when the American public discovered I've been filling my peanuts up with toxic pesticides, I decided to go on the Dick Cavett Show and do a little peanut jig. Yes, that's what you need, is a peanut jig of your own. Yes, a peanut jig of your own, yes.
Well, I don't know what that peanut or that fellow over there are saying, but I believe you should try to win back the marketplace with a more competitive business model.
Oh, wow, what a great idea.
Come on, no. Reagan.
Why did you invite us here in the first place?
I kind of thought that's what that was.
None of you are any help. Just get out. Get out now.
Mr. Boss? You're right?
Yeah, I'm fine, Alan. Just having fun. Why don't you go find a piece of cheese or something, man? I can't think with all this ruckus around me. I just need to go to my thinking room for a little while.
The war room.
Friends, of course. Fuck, it's genius. I did not think of that.
Look at yourself, weak loser. You deserve nothing. You know what you must do.
I can't.
I should do what I should have done.
Oh, God.
Start.
Here it goes.
Yeah, it came out, like I said, it came out like green and chunky. I've never seen it like that before.
Yeah, like I said, I'm not a doctor, so you should probably talk to someone that understands that stuff more.
Hey, what's with all the people?
And that is why you shouldn't try to better your life, because you might fail, so it's easy to fret out! That's not true! Help, help! That rotten pink man is trying to bully a mentally ill man like myself! Guards! Seize them!
Alan? What? They have a better 401k. Sorry.
I just have to note that it was only Pim that yelled something. I didn't say anything.
Oh! Now witness the brutal cruelties of reality!
Don't look, Charlie!
Is this really supposed to be? I mean, I've seen way worse stuff than this on the internet. I don't...
Oh, fuck.
My brothers, now the next step of our plan shall commence. You must all go and spread the word of Browning. Pretty soon, everyone will embrace sadness, and there'll be no such thing as smiling. And once that's done, we can finally eradicate all the Puerto Ricans on the planet. I mean, make everyone on the planet frown.
Puerto Rican.
Wait a minute, man. Oh, they don't, big nothing matters at all.
kill Puerto Ricans.
Your idea was so good that it drove me bonkers with jealousy. That's kind of cool, huh? Oh,
wow. Smiling feels good. Ooh. Ooh.
I think this next one's the last one.
So are they ever gonna make more? Or?
Oh yeah, they're gonna make more. This was huge.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Like, yeah, this is the last one. Charlie dies and doesn't come back. Our story. This is the one with ABGN.
Who to what? What?
Angry Video Game Nerds.
Oh, okay. Here works a group of gleeful critters dedicated to making the world a better place. They were all in the holiday spirit. That is, except for one nasty yellow one. Playing Mouse Quest?
No, he's playing Rust.
It does.
Oh, come on, let's spice up the office for these funny decorations.
Dude, what difference does it make? We get off work in like 5 minutes.
Hey, boys, before you scurry out of here, I got a last minute job for you. The job is for me, your favorite character, the boss. I just need a Christmas tree for the office.
That sounds marvelous! A Christmas adventure!
Come on, seriously? It's Christmas Eve, man. I was just about to go home.
It'll be fun, Charlie. One last job to end the year. Oh, this is gonna be great. I can't wait to find the perfect Christmas tree. Which one do you guys want to get? There's a bunch.
Yeah, look, let's just make it quick. I really want to be here all night.
What's up with you today, Charlie?
Huh? What are you talking about?
I don't know, it seems like you're agitated or something.
I'm not agitated, Pim. I just don't want to be working on Christmas Eve, and I think that's a pretty reasonable position to have.
When you're in this mood, I don't know if you realize, but it actually affects everyone else's mood. It brings us down a bit.
No, it affects you. Al, are you affected by the, whatever's supposed to be happening?
I don't really care. I just want to find a tree.
Okay, so in other words, she's not affected. See, here's the thing. Just because you are very positive and cheery about everything, does not mean everyone else has to conform to that.
I'm just saying, it seems like you're often in this mood. Like, it's not just a one-off thing. It seems like you're often like this.
What do you mean? What is that supposed to mean?
Well, it was the same with Desmond, wasn't it? I had to get you motivated for that.
Okay.
Charlie,
okay.
You didn't
want
to do that job,
okay.
And I had to get you motivated like I often have to do.
Okay. Yeah, really bringing stuff up from how many months ago. And also, that's a weird thing to bring up specifically because that was one of the instances where you were not in the best mood. So the fact that you're roping me to that thing and using that against me is
bringing stuff up, and it's not just Desmond.
Oh.
It's every job we do. You never want to do anything. It sometimes just gets a bit exhausting. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, look, I could do the same thing back to you. I could throw stuff at you.
Okay,
say it. Stuff
tell me.
I could say
what people
say
about
you.
Okay. How about this tree? Yes, fine.
Yeah,
let's
fine
do
to
it.
Me.
All right, Pim. Do you want to chop it down? Or
yeah. Sure. No. You know. Right, look, let me do it. I'll do it.
Careful, Charlie.
Pim, I'm just helping out, right? Something that I never do. According to you, here, right? Oh, is this? Thought this was hell.
Where's the actual fire?
All right, you've worn me down. This place isn't what it used to be. To be honest, Satan's been down in the dumps lately, and he hasn't been managing things well here. As a result, hell's literally frozen over.
Down in the dumps? Wait, I think I can actually help him. That's like what I do. I'm a smiling friend.
But if you try to leave, I'll pierce you with my evil pitchfork.
That's made out of cardboard, man.
You know what? I put a lot of work into this thing. Just leave. I actually don't want you here now. Just get out of here.
Uh-oh.
Get out of here.
He's gonna cry.
Go away.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I cursed and said damn in 1958 when I saw your grandfather being shot in the head by the Grotten burglar.
That seems a little bit unreasonable. I don't think you should be in hell for that. Grandma, you wouldn't happen to know where I could find Satan, would you?
Oh, of course. Just go down that scary hole right there. You'll find him at the bottom circle of hell.
Oh, sweet. Thanks, Grandma.
Oh, you should have a scrumptious piece of hard candy for the journey, Charlie. You know.
Oh, thank you, Grandma. I'm fine. Thank you, though.
Oh, my God. Oh,
I said I was going to do that if you did that again.
You're never leaving. Oh my God.
I just don't even care anymore. I just don't care anymore.
I know it might seem a little bit silly, but I think I can help cheer you up and get hell back to normal. I really wasn't ready to die yet, and I was thinking that if I succeeded, you could send me back to Earth.
Right. Deal.
Okay, well, I guess off the top of my head, have you tried,
One second. Yeah, it's unlocked. You can come in. Just right over there. Yeah, right over there. That's fine.
Very salty, yeah, big.
North your dispatch or the one next
to you? I think it's just something to do with the way the address shows up in the app. I mean, you know, it's not a problem. Don't worry about it.
Yeah. I just need to take a picture of the food really quick.
Yeah, all good.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thanks.
Good night.
Have a good one.
Happy holidays.
Merry Christmas. I hope they didn't forget to straw again. They always do. And they did. Great. They forgot it. Cool. Just what I wanted. Exactly what I wanted, actually. Cool. Sorry. You were saying something?
Anyways, as I was saying, it seems like you're unmotivated to do things because you're stuck in a loop of short-term dopamine rushes. Why don't you just try to start small at first, like eating healthier or something?
Are you seriously criticizing me?
No, not at all. I'm just trying to help, man.
You put me in a worse mood than I was in earlier.
All right, see, but look right there. That's a good example. You're avoiding the situation by taking a hit off that vape pen.
Enough! What
Tortured made you smile.
Well, I guess you're right.
Oh, sweet. So you're gonna let me go, right?
No, you pissed me the frick off, dude. I'm still gonna torture you forever, man. Forever, man.
No, what? No, that is not fair.
A deal's a deal.
Fucking Gilbert Gottfried.
That's what I thought.
Say a few words.
Charlie, what does it mean? Charlie, you were my everything. World's fucked up, man. Charlie, am I losing my goddamn mind? If it's gone, where will I find it?
Thank you for those beautiful words, Mr. Boss. Now, finally, we bid farewell to the dearly departed as he is laid to rest.
Christmas miracle.
Holy.
I can barely explain the many adventure I just went on. So I'm not going to. I don't want to talk about it. I see the devil.
Oh, Charlie. I'm sorry we had that nasty argument.
I'm completely naked. Be careful where your hand goes, dude.
And so that is how Charlie got his groove back. The end.
Oh, that was a wonderful story, Grandfather Glove. But did all of that really happen?
Yep. Hell is actually real. And Christianity was right all along. Sorry.
Oh.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
That's all of Smiling Friends.